Hello friends, after designing piston barrel and piston skirt, now we have moved on to one of the final aspect, or you can say one of the final and vital aspect of our piston design, which is piston pin. But before getting into that, we should discuss about what is this piston pin, what is this function of this piston pin, and how it is one of the most important feature in our piston. So this piston pin is also called a gudgeon pin, or you can say wrist pin. Clear? Because it has also, why it is called a wrist pin? Because it has also, it works as our wrist. Clear? It connects two portion. Clear? In case of our piston, is piston as well as connecting. So this piston pin act as a connection between piston and connecting rod. So this connecting rod, here I have shown a portion of our piston in which our piston pin is placed inside our piston, and this area, this oval shaped area, it is nothing but the projected area which comes under our connecting rod. Here, so this piston pin, it connects connecting rod and our piston through this area. So now this piston pin, it will comes under immense pressure of a gas due to gas, as well as it takes inertia forces of our connecting rod and crankshaft. So it has to withstand again two types of forces. So this piston pin material should be depending on these two type of forces. Bending force is a major force in case of our piston pin. So as well as this bending force is also create bearing stress. Clear? Bearing stress due to this our connecting rod which is projected or on our piston pin. So gas pressure will create bearing pressure or bearing stress, and due to placement and support at piston, it will also create bending stress. How this bending stress? Because this support created or supported by this piston is eccentric to our central load, and our central load is acted due to this gas pressure P. Here you can say gas pressure P, which is acting directly upon our piston through our connecting rod. This is projected area of connecting rod, which is represented by L1, and it is this force or gas pressure is supported by two forces which is equally distributed at the distance of L2 on piston, which is P by 2, or you can say force, total force divided by 2. This force is represented by F in this case, so you can also call it as a F rather than P. Clear? So it is F by 2. This force is nothing but force generated by gas pressure. So ultimately this force is nothing but a gas pressure force. This force, due to its eccentricity, will create bending stress, and directly due to this area comes under this pin, area comes under connecting rod, it will also create a bearing stress. Due to this, we have to select a material which can withstand this bearing stress as well as bending stress. So what could be the material for this? It should be a steel alloy. It should have a good amount of stress, because bending is a phenomenon which can easily affect your component. So it should show good amount of strength against that. So we are going to use steel alloys, which is also determined, or you can also add some amount of molybdenum, vanadium, to increase the strength. Clear? This pin is hollow. Why we are putting this as a hollow? Because it should have minimum amount of weight to nullify our inertia forces. It is fixed by a circlip, or you can say a pin, or you can say bushing provided at the end of our piston. There are two types of pin in it. One is fully floating and semi-floating. In case of fully floating pin, it can float inside our piston as well as under our connecting rod. So it can easily move relative to, in case of fully floating pin, it can easily move under piston as well as inside our connecting rod. and in semi-floating, it can move relative to our piston, but it can't move relative to our connecting rod. So it can move more of a connected or fixed with our connecting rod. So there are two types of piston pin. One is fully floating and one is semi-floating. In fully floating case, it can move around relative to both of the component, piston and connecting rod. But in case of semi-floating, it can only move relative to piston rather than connecting rod. It is fixed with our connecting rod. Clear? So material should be steel alloys, which should have strength between 710 MPa to 900 MPa. Clear? Now, determining stresses. So one is bending stress and another is bearing stress. Bending stress, as you know, if I am putting some beam, simply supported beam or any kind of beam, it will create a stress due to eccentricity of loading. When loads or forces and support are not in same line, if it is eccentric, then it will create bending in your component. And what is bearing stress? Bearing stress is a stress due to the projection of any component on our any component on other component, which is directly in contact with each other, which is trying to create pressure due to the surface area, and which is ultimately deform that surface area, that is called bearing pressure. And it is more of due to a projected area. Clear? So there are two stress here, or there are two forces here. One is gas pressure and another is inertia force. These two forces ultimately create bearing stress and bending stress. First of all, we are going to design for this gas pressure depending on this bearing stress. So force due to gas pressure, or you can say gas load, which is pi by 4 d square into p, we are going to call it as a F. This force is F, which is pi by 4 d square into p, where d is outside diameter of piston, p is maximum gas pressure, which is supported by area under our connecting load. Here, why only area under connecting load? Because this bearing pressure is always increase or always occurs due to two different surfaces in contact. Remaining portion of our pin is not in contact with our connecting load, so that area we are not going to consider while we are determining this bearing stress. Clear? So supporting load, or you can say supporting phenomenon, will be PE1, which is our bearing pressure, and which we are going to take as a 25 MPa in case of steel alloy pin. Clear? And DO is outside diameter of our piston pin, and L1 is length of connecting rod. You can say length of our connecting rod on our piston pin, which is also width of small end of connecting rod, and it is taken as a 0.45 of our total diameter. So here L1 represented by area under connecting rod is nothing but 0.45 of our total diameter. So from this equation, clear? Because this gas load should be supported by this bearing force, clear? Or you can say reactive force, more of a. So depending on that, you can easily determine L1, or you can say D1, PO. Clear? L1 you can find out from this equation, 0.45. If you have a diameter of your piston, you can easily find out L1. Clear? And from that, you can easily determine this DO, outside diameter of your piston pin. After that, we are going to design this piston pin for inertia, against inertia force, or you can say more of a bending stress. How this bending stress will going to occur in case of our piston? So this bending stress will going to create effect which is called a bending moment. How? So this force F, here we will write it as a F rather than P, not to get confused with pressure and force. Clear? So this force F at exactly at the center of our piston, and ultimately it is supported by two points, which is called F2 and F2, clear, which has a distance of L2. So For this, we are going to use our equation which is called bending stress equation M by I. M by I is equal to sigma B upon Y, where M is bending moment due to this force F, I is moment of inertia for our section, our pin section, clear? Bending stress, or you can say limiting bending stress, and ultimately Y, which is half distance of our element. So, M, depending on the simply supported beam, moment will be determined by, or you can say directly you can write it, FD upon 8, which is force into diameter, which is total length upon 8, which is your, which will be going to be your bending moment, or you can say moment generated. Clear? I, for hollow section, it is hollow. Clear? For hollow section, it is pi by 4, dO raised to 4 minus dI raised to 4. For a circular section, pi by 64, dO, d raised to 4. So in this case, pi by 64, dO raised to 4 minus dI raised to 4. Here, your dI will be 0.6 of dO. So in this equation, you can easily relate this two and make this equation of any one of them. Here, after that y which is dO by dx. So ultimately you can determine geometric, or you can say different aspect or diameter and length of your piston pin depending on this final equation. Sigma B will depending or will going to be your material strength and moment, which is generated by FD by 8, where F is with what force? F is gas pressure force. Here I have mentioned D is outer diameter. In this case, DO will be determined by this equation where you have L1. How you are going to determine L1? To 0.45 of D. Here you can easily find out DO. Clear? Because we have each and every aspect, like you have maximum pressure, diameter, PB1 will be given, which is also 25 megapascal for a steel alloy. From this bearing pressure, you can determine DO. DO means outer diameter of your pin, and after determining that DO, you can easily determine DI. How? Here you have a force as well as outside diameter. You don't have this two, DO and DI. So you can easily find out DO and DI depending on this relation. DI is equal to 0.6 of DO. Sigma B is limiting bending stress for particular material, which is steel alloy, which will be around 480 megapascal and 780. Y is DO by 2, also you have found in this. So ultimately you can easily found DI. So this is how your piston pin design will going to happen. After this design, one can easily determine different aspect of our piston. Here we are done with our each and every aspect of piston. Clear? In this piston pin, what we have learned, we have developed a model which comes under two type of stresses. One is bearing stress and another is bending stress. This stress is generated by two aspects. One is gas pressure, another is inertia forces. Depending on that, we have determined, first of all, we have determined the stress due to bearing stress, and from that stress we have determined outside diameter of pin, and ultimately depending on this bending stress we have determined inside diameter. So this is your piston pin, also a bludgeon pin, wrist pin, you can call any of them. Here material should be a steel alloy because it has to withstand against different types of bending stress as well as gas pressure. So this is our design of piston. Let's have a quick recap of each and every aspect. First, we have designed piston head, which is for two types, for two stresses. One is direct stress and another is gas or thermal stress. Clear? There are two thickness equations for that. After that we have designed different aspect of a ring section from T1 to T2 to B1 to B2 to G, which is gap between two ends. Clear? After that we have designed piston barrel and piston skirt, which ultimately given us a total length of piston, and finally we have designed piston pin, which connects a connecting rod and our piston. So here we are done with design of our piston. In next video we will discuss and case study, or you can say example of this piston. Thank you, and we are done with it.